Hello students, good morning all of you. In the last class we have studied the third lesson of part 1, storage of water. Yesterday I have given the exercise of this lesson. Are you completed in your class workbook? Each answer three times. Okay, now today we are going to discuss part 2, third lesson, Maratha Sardars, the famous house of the Bhosles. Okay, part 2, third lesson. Take out textbooks, all of you, page number 8. Now, today I am going to take the introduction of this lesson, okay? Yes, first point is period of unrest. What's the first point? Period of unrest means the sons preached devotion to God and the Maratha Sardars started a tradition of this bravery. So, this was the period of unrest. Unrest means no peace, okay, because the two sultans, the Adil Shah of Bijapur and the Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar, were constantly at the wars, and they made the armies of the Maratha Sardars in these wars. Why? Because the brave Maratha Sardars, the second point is the brave Maratha Sardars means the Marathas were both brave and tough. They were fearless, not fear. Okay, they were very brave and they were very proud of their achievements in their battlefield. So the Maratha Sardars and he with a spear in hand and a sword at the side would ride in his Sardars cavalry. So if any Sardar went to Sultan with his army, the Sultan gave his employment, means any work or job, the Sultan gave him the employment and make him a Sardar of his kingdom. If any Sardar went with his army, so the Sultan gave him his job in their kingdom and gave a jagir, and the Sultan who received such a jagir considered himself a Raja. Okay, so there were many Maratha Sardars at the court of the Ahmednagar and Bijapur. So let us see the famous Sardars like Jadhavs of Sindhkhets, Nimbalkars of Paltan, Gorpades of Mudol, Mores of Javli, Bhosles of Veru. So the Sindhkhet Jadhavs were descendants of the Yadavs of Devagiri. And the Jizabai, the mother of Shivaji Maharaj, was the daughter of Lakhuji Rav Jadhav of Sindhkhet. Okay. Jizabai. Who is Jizabai? The mother of Shivaji Maharaj. She is the daughter of Lakhuji Rav Jadhav of Sindhkhet. Now the third point, the tradition of valour. Okay, all these Sardars were very brave but not united. But many of them were sworn enemies of each other. They will not think about they should unite and to do something for the people. Always they are enemies of one another. Okay, especially they kept alive the warlike spirit, especially among the young people. Many famous soldiers were born in the families who kept alive the tradition of valour. Among these, the famous families, the Bhosles of Veru, showed a great bravery. Let us see the temple of Grishneshwar. Next point is the tradition of Grishneshwar. It was the temple about 400 years ago. The temple of Grishneshwar, where it is near the Veru caves, was falling to pieces. The walls also developed cracks. The priest had deserted the temple. There were no lights. And they were thus the temple which will built in honor to a great god was totally neglected. Means it was totally deserted. No one thought of to repair the temple. So a great devotee of Shiva visited the temple regularly. Who is? Let us see now. He would put flowers, bale on the lingam and pray to God. He carried the temple's extensive repairs to the temples and restored to its original condition. He thought that he would make the renovation of these temples and made arrangement in proper maintenance of the temples. Now, in this temple, there were lights both inside, outside, and the temple lost grandeur of Grishneshwar was restored to its original condition. Who was this devotee who did all this work? Do you know who is? He was a Maloji Raje Bhosle. Now see, who is Maloji Raje Bhosle? Who is? Maloji Raje Bhosle, the Patil of Verur. Who is? Maloji Raje Bhosle, the Patil of Verur. Was a great devotee of Shiva. So, now see the Bhosle's family. Babaji Raje had two sons. Babaji Raje had two sons. Who is? Maloji Raje and Vithoji Raje. Maloji Raje was the elder and the Vithoji Raje was the younger. Maloji Raje Bhosle had two sons. Babaji Raje had two sons. Maloji Raje and Vithoji Raje. Maloji Raje was the elder and the Vithoji Raje was younger. Babaji Raje Bhosle had the rights of a patil in the Verur village. And Maloji Raje and Vithoji Raje were brothers. They were both were very brave. They had the service in Maratha armed in many armed Maratha troops. It was a period of great unrest because the Mughal emperor from Delhi had attacked the king of Nizam Shah. And then Daulatabad was the capital of Nizam Shah. Malik Ambar was his wazir or the chief minister. Malik Ambar was able and wise. The capable and brave brothers from Verul soon caught his attention. On his recommendation, the Shah conferred Maloji Raje the Jagir of Pune, Supe and Parganas. The Maloji Raja has given the Jagir of Pune, Supe and Parganas. So, the Bhosle become very rich and powerful. Maloji Raja's wife was Umabai. She came from the house of Nimbalkars of Paltan. They had two sons. Maloji Raja also had two sons. Who is? That is Shahaji and Sharifji. Maloji Raja was killed in the Battle of Indapur. Now, Vithoji Raja looked after their children and their Jagir. Later, he asked marriage for Shahaji. And the daughter of Lakhuji Rao Jadhav, Jizabai, the daughter of Lakhuji Rao Jadhav, was married with Shahaji Raja. He celebrated the wedding of Shahaji Raja and Jizabai with the great pomp. Jizabai became the fortune of the Bhosle's family. Now the Shahaji Raja. Now let us see. Shahaji Raja Nizam Shah transferred Shahaji Raja. The Jagir had conferred on Maloji Raja. So Shahaji Raja was a very brave and capable in respect at the court of Nizam Shah. So the Mughal emperor decided the kingdom to conquer the kingdom of Nizam Shah. For this he made a plan with Adil Shah of Bijapur. Malik Ambar and Shahaji Raja fought bravely to save Nizam Shahi. They defeated both the enemies. This battle took place at Bhatawadi near Ahmednagar. Sharifji was killed in this battle. Shahaji Raja displayed great valor. He was praised everywhere as a brave general. His reputation in the court was so enhanced that Malik Ambar began to feel jealous to see him. This gradually led to antagonism between them. As a result, Shahaji Raja left Nizam Shahi and joined the court of Adil Shah of Bijapur. Adil Shah honored him with a title Sir Lashkar, means the chief of this army. Later, there were very developments in Nizam Shahi. The Wazir Malik Ambar died. His scheming son Fateh Khan became the Wazir of Nizam Shahi. During this period, the Nizam Shahi began to decline. At the same time, there was a great threat of Mughal aggression. So, Nizam Shah's mother appealed, means Nizam Shah's mother requested to Shahaji Raja to return and save the Nizam Shahi. So, Shahaji Raja decided to left Adil Shahi and joined the Nizam Shahi. Because the request of Nizam Shah, to save Nizam Shah, okay? Because the Nizam Shah mother requested to Shahaji Raja to save Nizam Shahi. That's why Shahaji Raja left Adil Shahi and returned to Nizam Shahi. So, next video we will discuss detail about this lesson. Okay?